I'd like to introduce me. I am from Spain, from Valencia. I'm Rubén González. And I thanks to the organization and my friends, Abilio and Laszlo, and all of you. Okay? Abilio, comentales que.
Okay, I will try to translate, so sorry, I don't know Hungarian. I would like, maybe. We need to learn. Yeah. Well, our idea, we have 2 hours, I think so, more or less. Ruben's idea is to focus the workshop in two different aspects. One, as you know, how to make small ground bases or dioramas or what you need. And on the other hand, his concept about AFVs or military vehicles weathering, you know, mainly using artisoils and how he managed to produce effects. So he's going to do both things, maybe half the time, an hour, doing the demo with the grounds, and the other part, another hour, with the, as you see, there are some turrets to do the demo. You want to say, okay. If you want.
Vannak esetleg magyarok, akik meg kell fordítani?
Jó az angol, jó az angol.
Oké.
Oké, perfect. Oké.
Bueno, pues empezamos con los terrenos y...
Bueno, puede, porque no vas dejando los óleos, explicamos que primero los depositas, sí, vale, y todo, vale, el tema.
Bueno, empezamos por explicar el tema,
okay,
de la base.
¿Vale? Exactamente.
Comentarles que estamos trabajando con las nuevas pinturas Real Color, que son similares a las de Tamiya.
Ok, bueno. First, he's going to show you how to proceed to prepare the old paints. As you know, AK Interactive, it has a new range of paints, as you know, Real Colors. It's lacquer-based painted, similar to Tamiya and Gunfe. You can mix all together. You can use Tamiya lacquer thinner, Tamiya white cap thinner. It doesn't matter. You can airbrush. So he applied one of the new tones in this turret. So it's going to be everything onto the new lacquer-based Real Color paints.
Okay. Una vez hemos preparado la base, que es lo más importante.
¿Lo deja secar? ¿Cuánto?
Sí, la idea, yo trabajo con una cosa detrás de otra. Es decir, aplico la base, aclaro la base, aclaro sus cruces un poco, y en cuanto seca te pones a trabajar. No hay ningún
okay,
problema.
He primed the vehicle, apply the first layer. It depends on the green, cream, white, panzer brown. It doesn't matter. One is dry. He
al tacto.
To the touch, and you see it's dry. You can go ahead. You don't need to wait 2, 3, 4, 25 hours. You can go straight ahead. You finish to airbrush, and in 5 minutes probably is touch dry. You can go ahead.
Lo primero que hacemos es aplicar los lavados, bueno, filtros si cabe. Yo no suelo aplicar filtros, pero
his technique is quite different, because you know that we can do the weathering in the vehicles applying filters or washes. Rubens doesn't usually apply filters. He go straight ahead to the washes. Okay.
Los lavados los suelo aplicar con una mezcla de óleo y esmalte. Correcto.
You know that our range of products, this is enamel based, you know, you can dilute or thing with the odorless thinner, but Rubens usually mix this kind of product with oils, make a mix.
Para retrasar un poco, esto seca rápido y luego no se remueve.
This is a dry fast product, so if you want
Además, luego no se remueve bien, es decir, una vez se seca, cuesta más de...
So it's better to add a mix with the oils, so it leaves you more time to change and manage and do the weathering properly. Because if you apply this and let it dry during maybe half an hour or an hour, it's going to be difficult to remove. So if you mix, you have more time to do it.
Me voy a, bueno, y una vez tienes los lavados, ya aplicar los óleos. El óleo es bueno porque lo puedes remover, lo puedes cambiar, lo puedes.
As you know, the oil is very easy to remove, to manage, to do the effects because it takes a long time to dry.
Además, puedes conseguir un montón de efectos por la potencia que tiene el óleo en sí, porque se pueden hacer un montón de cosas, degradados, lavados de nuevo, filtros.
You can go back and further with the oils. As you can see, he's putting a few drops of the colors into a piece of cardboard. A couple of things about our Aptalum 502 oils. You can use any kind of oil. It doesn't matter because oil is oil. But one of the main advantages of this one is that it's engineered to be used on military vehicles and is matte finish and has less linseed oil. You know that the oil that every tube has inside here is less than in the usual artist oils. So this is one of the differences.
Ahora mismo, además, se puede utilizar, utilizamos diluyentes de secado rápido.
¿Tienes ahí?
Y con efecto mate. Lo cual mejora.
¿Y déjamelo
todavía?
¿El otro normal no lo has traído?
No.
Ok. There are a couple of new products. This is fast dry thinner, and this is matte effect thinner. If you see this one, I want to show you. Is if you leave on the table, in a few minutes you will see that on the bottom there is decanted the matte product inside. So you have to gently stir, and then you can use. So Ruben usually use
a mix of
these two and a mix, but you can use the regular odorless thinner.
Yo suelo trabajar con una paleta de óleos reducida. O sea, yo no suelo utilizar 8 o 10 colores, sino que siempre utilizo un color claro, un color medio y un par de colores oscuros.
Sí, le explico el tema como en el.
Exacto. Vale.
Okay, depending of the color that you want to do the weathering, this is light, there is a green. Ruben usually use 4-5 tones, no more. Doesn't need any 10 or 12 oil colors. A light shade, a dark shade, and maybe two intermediate colors. Maybe with 4 colors, you can do all the weathering. Doesn't need 10 or 12.
Okay. Y otra paleta diferente para el tema de los óxidos, que ahora veremos.
Okay. Okay. La luz, espérate.
Ahí
se ve. Vale.
Vale. Además, comentarles algo que yo no suelo trabajar con el punteado.
Ah,
vale.
Vale. Sí, no.
Eso ahora cuando.
You will see that you know the if you do military vehicles, you know that there is the dog technique. The dog technique means that you in the surface add a lot of dots with oil and then you blend together with the surface. Ruben doesn't use that technique. You will see that he does the weathering in a different way. Not better, not worse, it's different.
Es muy importante tener un buen surtido de pinceles.
¿Vale? Yes, it's important to have a lot of good, bad, but both brushes. It's important because it's the tool that we are going to use. Sometimes you see the model that invests a lot of money in products, and it doesn't matter the brand, in the model kit. And then when you see the brushes, they are all shit. So invest money in the brushes is because it's the is what we use. It's the main tool. It's important. Okay. Brushes right now in the market, they are not so expensive. You can buy a regular, like the orange one, the regular, it costs.
Los sintéticos.
It's synthetic, maybe 1.50 euros. And then you can use the new ones, maybe 5 or 6 euros. And if you care of them, it will last a few modules.
Suelo utilizar ahora los, antes utilizaba los sintéticos para los óleos, pero se les gastan enseguida. Entonces ahora estoy utilizando los nuevos, que es una serie económica, pero son de Marta y aguantan
mucho. Aquí, maybe you can see that is is Marta Kolinsky.
Pero es la serie
barata. But it's the basic serie. It's not, they are not expensive because the difference with the synthetics is that if you use oils, synthetics tend to open the Brussels. This is much better, and this is a good tool to use with the oils.
Voy a empezar a aplicar un poco. Bueno, tu comentario es que esta base está tratada con el Real Color de base, el chipping y el blanco.
Okay. The base color is Russian green, a real color Russian green. Then the tienes ahí el
chipping, no.
The chipping medium, okay, and then a layer of white, and you have removed and you see the first white wash.
Okay.
Ahora como está en esa postura se ve muy bien.
Así.
Sí. Ahora enseña a la cámara cuál es, para que se vea. Sí, pero para el primero te puede ver.
Sí.
Ponlo ahí al lado que se vea así.
¿Se ve?
Ok. The first, this one was too light, so he added a little bit of dark neutral gray to make it darker.
Ahora al añadirle el óleo, lo que
you know, he's missing with the oils. Ay, nunca te la mano. Porque si pones la mano delante no se ve.
Sí,
ahí,
sí.
Ok. Así, así.
Y aplico. Vale. Voy a aplicar y luego voy fundiendo. A medida que voy añadiendo.
As you see, he's not doing small dots of oils. He's applying a big layer.
Voy fundiendo, voy añadiendo, voy a crear sombras, voy a crear algún efecto.
He's adding different shades of the same tone.
Lo más importante es al final que le dé riqueza cromática. Que,
The most important is to little by little to add contrast and depth in the surface of the model. You have to have in mind that right now the effect is so is so dark, is so harsh, and you can see, but later the effect will subtly tone down.
Bueno, los desconchones vendrían después. Es decir, ahora solo vamos a trabajar óleos, vamos a trabajar.
He's only going to use Rhinite oils, and then when the oils are dry and you are satisfied, you can do the chipping if you want.
Se ve un tipo
de... Sí, pero si lo giras tanto para allá, no lo tienes ya. Que poner más para acá.
Sí.
Ah, sí. Así sí se ve, así.
Las 9 de ayer.
Bueno, pero total, si esto hace
que sí. Sí, comentarles que si alguien tiene una pregunta.
You can ask what you want, ¿eh? Okay.
Ahora estoy trabajando en las superficies horizontales.
Ahora lo vamos a pasar, sí, eso.
Sí, sí, sí. En las superficies horizontales, lo que aplicamos son degradados, nuestras. Luego haremos barridos en las superficies verticales.
On the upper surface, as they are horizontal, he's going to use like a mapping technique. Then on the lateral surfaces, they will do some streaking grind.
Les has dicho que si alguien tiene pegas.
Sí, 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 sí.
Hay que comentar una cosa también, Arilio. Cuando aplicas los óleos o demás,
sí,
van apareciendo cercos. Para que no aparezcan cercos, lo que hay que tratar es de humedecer toda la superficie.
Okay. ¿Vale? As you know, if when you are using this kind of enamel products, you can see that the surface has all the blurring effects on top. To avoid that, you have to wet all the surface. Okay.
No solo donde lo aplicas, sino el resto.
Y ahora sí, eso lo puede pasar.
Sí. Ahora viene eso que acabo de explicar. Ahora, si te fijas, hay medio, ¿se ve ahí? Media.
Sí, lo pone. Ok, as you can see, half of the turret roof is wet. And as he's going to go to the back of the turret, he's going to wet the rest of the surface.
Ahora humedezco toda y luego continúo trabajando. Ok. Secarla, o sea, humedecerla entera ya no me aparecerá.
Pásala, sí, 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 la vea.
Pásala por allí, que la de. Sobre esto voy a preparar, bueno, sobre esta prepararemos una zona de óxido. Ahora voy a hacer algún barrido aquella. Si alguien tiene una pregunta. Mira lo que te decía del foam. Eso, esa pared es de foam del nuestro.
Yeah, I would like to ask you. I heard that you do use NF filters and render fitting.
Yeah.
Rendering. So also low washes like
what? The next part?
Excuse me?
The last part of the question. What?
You don't use,
No. Okay. Okay. No, no, no. Le, te está preguntando que si realmente tú no utilizabas los filtros.
Y le no.
He doesn't usually use the filters. He jumped from the varied surface to apply oils, doing washes maybe. So dark and with different shades.
Depende también. A veces quieres crear un contraste entre una superficie. Imagínate, por ejemplo, en este caso,
okay.
¿Vale? Y quieres crear una superficie entre estas dos planchas y el resto. Quieres crear una diferencia. En ese caso sí que puedes aplicar un.
In the, if you see in this turret, if you want to make a difference between one of the two parts that you see all the welding, you can add a filter. To do maybe like a different painting or something like that. He's going to add a filter to see. But a filter is so thin.
Vamos a aplicar uno. Vamos a cambiarle un poquito el color. Aunque lo vamos a aplicar con óleo, ¿vale? Porque no tengo ninguno, pero vamos a aplicar uno. Bueno, espérate ahora que acaben con esa ahí, ¿no?
No, así que.
O lo aplicamos.
He's going to apply a filter. El dedo, bájalo.
Ahí. Es como cubro toda la superficie, ¿vale? Intentando no encharcar y ahora la voy a limpiar un poquito.
Once you apply the surface, you see now with the thinner, you remove
observe the bright paint, how to don't destroy it with don't darken it.
¿Tú proteges las maquetas? ¿Tú le aplicas barniz?
No, no, yo nunca aplico barniz.
Okay,
porque yo creo que... Claro, eso depende de la forma de trabajo de cada uno. Mi forma de trabajo no hace que la pintura... Aunque machaco mucho las maquetas,
sí,
tengo la suerte de que la pintura me aguanta, ¿vale?
Ok. Rubén, his way of modeling and do the weathering, he usually does not overdo the effects. So,
a pesar de que soy muy salvaje con... es que...
A couple of things regarding your question. If you see a model from Ruben in the flesh, once finished, you will see a lot of contrasts, the deep surfaces, a large amount of weathering effects, because he likes to add a lot of effects in the models.
The weathering models.
Okay, but he works layer by layer. So if you do something like that and you see that it's a difference between one part and the other, and you let it dry, and you go step by step, layer by layer, you don't need to protect the surface. He doesn't use any varnish.
No, never.
Nor me. I don't use varnish because if you know gloss varnish and matte varnish, when you apply over a surface, changes. Es like a filter.
Y además los efectos se atenúan. Es decir, cuando tú vas trabajando
con
diferentes materiales, consigues...
What?
Decal application. No. When he applying decals.
No.
Solamente...
But only in the area.
Only.
The gloss varnish, you apply the decal with the products, another layer of gloss varnish, and then... But not the whole model, only that area.
Pero en el caso de tanques, yo intento evitar usar calcas, es decir, mascarillas, transfers.
He usually doesn't like to use decals. If it's possible, it's better to paint it if you want. Use stencils instead of decals.
Eso está pintado.
This is painted.
Painted.
Yes. When you are brush with a layer of varnish, the surface changes dramatically. So sometimes you add a lot of work and weathering effects and you say, okay, I'm going to protect the model. And if you apply the varnish not properly, or even it's a bad varnish, it can change the look of the surface.
Sí, y los brillos que consigues, y es muy interesante cuando trabajas con diferentes materiales, es muy interesante porque el óleo produce un brillo, el esmalte produce otro, el acrílico otro, y eso hay que conservarlo. Si tú barnizas, lo unificas todo.
Okay? Usually you can add even wet effects. So, for example, if on a part of the surface you add some wet effects and close to that area some matte effects like pigments, there is a rich, a high contrast, but if you apply varnish, it's lost.
Okay.
Vamos a pasar este.
Sí.
Now you will see.
It's wet enough, but
it's wet, and you can see how it has changed. Sometimes it happens to me. I have some models in the show and in the articles. Rubens is very tough to me, and I understand why. Because I make a lot of effects, but they are so subtle, and you can hardly see. I can be working a small surface hours and hours, doing microchipping, and then he say, I can see nothing. We have to make it more with more contrast, because, okay, this is a hobby, but at the end, if you put two models on a table with less and higher contrast, you will be attracted by this one. And he's only saying to me, more contrast, because, okay, there is a certain amount of contrast, but no, it doesn't mean that the model has to be too dark. But no, you can
no, hay
have...
que, no hay que mentir tampoco, pero entre la parte superior y la parte inferior, que siempre está en contacto con el suelo, tú puedes hacer.
In his models, the upper part of the model, the tour and everything, thank is you. Usually much lighter than the lower hood.
Okay.
Okay.
Bueno, voy a continuar con este haciendo. Bueno, vamos a añadir alguna cosilla más por la parte de arriba y luego iremos a vale, ¿no? Iremos a la parte a las partes verticales.
Vale. El dedo para atrás. Ahí.
Vamos a añadir ahí este tono verde.
Si tú quisieras todavía podrías retirar lo que ya parece que
sí,
está seco.
Sí, 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 sí.
Okay,
sí.
It's important. As you can see in front of the turret, the part that is finished, okay? You can see, okay, I don't like what I have done. You can remove easily with thinner. So sometimes we need to go and do things with more contrast, because if not, you can reduce.
Esta parte que es alrededor de la escotilla y demás.
Around the hatches is going to increase the amount of contrast. As you can see, you don't need to have to do it very accurate and straight ahead and taking a lot of care. You can go.
Es una cuestión de.
And in thinking about what is the effect that you want to do. Lo que mientras podemos ir haciendo,
sí.
Si quieres pasar también algún terreno para que lo vayas.
Sí, 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 pásalo y que vayas.
Okay, we can do something else in advance,
sí.
As you can do his working.
Si no les importa que haga las dos
maybe,
cosas.
Maybe sometimes we can pass all the small bases and you can see. And then you maybe some people is more interested in this than in the vehicle. We're going to pass everything in different steps.
Yes.
You can see different sometimes, some of them are finished. I think the best is to go that way. If you start, everybody can see the same. Start this way.
Claro que faltaría toda la parte de desconchones
para
poder hacer más el oxígeno.
So, sometimes it's useful to have at home, you know, all kits and try the effects first, and when you are satisfied, you can do in the real model. Because sometimes we are so enjoying in the model and we do the things, and maybe it's too late.
Dile que yo estropeo muchos modelos.
He has damaged a lot of models, but it's the best way to improve.
Y de nuevo mezclo óleo, en este caso he cogido dos tonos anaranjados, ¿vale? De nuevo lo mezclo con...
The oil, the rust is a mix of two oils, okay? And rust streaks.
Es anaranjado.
It's not really important. The name or the color is just that the effect that you want to achieve. Sometimes we are focused, which is the number, which is the name. The important is to know what we want to do. because maybe you do not have this at home and you have a different orange from Wilson and Newton, maybe another different brand. El dedo.
¿Qué?
El dedo. Sí. Ahí está. Do you see the difference in the filter side and the other? It's clear.
Yes.
If I wish to do this because sometimes me or maybe you do the same effect but with less contrast, so there is no difference. Sí.
De nuevo lo aplico.
He's adding the rust effects around the hatch, the ring. As you can see, you do not have to be very, very subtle. He's not subtle working, as you can see. Some people think that Rubens is working so subtle, but no.
He's so
wild doing the things. In fact, I think that we as modelers, we don't need to copy any other models. We only need to know how they work and try to do our best. I know Ruben maybe 30 years, maybe, probably. I love his work, but I never tried to copy him because there is only one Ruben, there is only one Van Gils, there is only one of any. Va a darle más al fondo. Sigue.
Sí.
Once he finished to do this and you see, he's going to do some demo the other hour in the ground. Because, well, he told me early in the morning, we are being all the weekend here with all of you enjoying the show and drinking and everything. So, this is the same technique that he used. Voy a explicar que hace lo mismo en los terrenos,
sí,
por eso es importante.
Sí, correcto.
The way he works the turret, the military vehicles, is the same he used to do the weathering on the ground. So this is the way, if you see how he does here, he's going to work here the same way. These new products, they are on acrylic, dry, fast dry, and you can see that the surface is foam. This is foam used to separate the glasses when they under the walls.
Insulation.
Thank you. Insulation. So he carved with a knife and with a metallic brush. Okay, very 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 hard. And when you have the surface, you only need to open the bottle and to apply.
Es que tengo un USB, si la televisión tiene USB.
Sí.
¿Sí?
Ese tiene seguro.
Lo pinchamos y pinchamos
so,
las cosas.
You will see that when you apply the product over the surface, you only have, the first step is to let it dry around half an hour, and then with a brush or with a sponge, you increase the defect. And then when it's dry, ¿cuánto tarda en secar? Totalmente. Las pasas.
En un par de horas.
In a couple of hours, in 2 hours, you can start to apply the oils to do the different effects. So this is the same way.
Does the TV have a USB connection? I think so.
Yeah, there is.
Okay.
Yes.
Pero espérate cuando acabe.
Sí, ahora cuando acabe.
No, you guys have slides or
he has, yes, once he finishes this, he's going to plug in the USB.
All right.
Once he finishes and you see this, he's going to plug into the TV, one of USB, and you will see the process at the same time he's doing here. Two different.
Bien, con los óxidos hay que ser mucho más cuidadoso, quiero decir, como sobre la parte que habíamos filtrado, como la hacemos anaranjada, podemos aplicar óxidos y podemos ahí conseguir el efecto de oxidación, pero hay que ser más fino a la hora de aplicar los chorretones y demás.
He said that you have to be more subtle when doing the rust streaks. Okay? The filter is easy, you can see, but you need to invest more time doing a great rust effects. Because at the top of the streak has to be darker and faded at the end.
El otro, la otra torreta está hasta ahí. La otra torreta para pincharla.
Sí.
También que la vea.
Sí.
Once you finish the turret. Because we need to insert in this one, okay? It's alive. Yeah.
Is this the speed he normally works at?
Ah, okay.
Or is this for like demonstration?
Okay, good question. I know the answer, but he's going to tell you. Que si está la velocidad que realmente tú trabajas en casa o lo estás haciendo para la demo.
Yo suelo trabajar así. Yo, es decir, vamos a ver, ahora estoy tratando de exagerar el efecto y demás. En casa quizá sean, inviertes más horas porque son más capas, pero es mi velocidad de trabajo, no...
Okay. Rubens said that here he has speed up a little bit the process because he wants to show you in an hour how to do the effects. But he's not so slow working. He works fast. He's working fast. Maybe a little less than here, but at home he works fast because he's professional, his work. He wake up early in the morning, we go to work, he goes to make models. So all the day, 8 hours, making
all
models.
All the day painting models, no. All the day writing.
And writing articles, and you know, but he's...
And take photos, okay?
And taking photos and the article, but he works fast.
Yo trabajo rápido, yo... Sí, está todo rápido.
Fine. This is brand new, it's not open.
Toma, ahora abre la fuerza de ya.
Déjame un palillo o algo para que ellos vean un poco la textura.
Sí.
Ok, con el palillo.
Vale, con eso.
Ok, you can check even the texture, the smell and everything. I think the best is to go this way.
With
that
water.
Way.
Que comentales que son acrílicas, que con agua.
Yeah. Take what you need.
Yes.
Yeah.
Que todas se diluyen con agua.
All the range are acrylic. You can use only water. Even for cleaning the brushes and the hands and everything. ¿Cómo quedas?
Esta también es muy interesante.
¿Qué?
este el asfalto que voy a explicarles cómo.
Ah, ok, ok, ok. ¿Pero traes uno vacío? No, ah, aquí, aquí, aquí.
Sí, claro.
Ok. While you are looking the texture, he's going to show you how you how to apply the asphalt. Because it's a different, slightly different. The paste is the same. The smell is the same, the color.
Pero es muy simple, es decir, para aplicarlo y conseguir ese efecto, simplemente aplicar la pasta y ya está. Okay.
He's going to use a spatula, very thin and flat. Let's see, because this is the most important. If you want to do this is the most important step to do it. You have the core, you see, you take the paste from the spatula.
Ay.
Wait.
¿Se ve?
Ahora, okay. Do not try to do with another different tool because it's going to be difficult. This is quite simple with the right spatula, okay? The right tool. Sí. Sí, 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 se ve perfectamente, se ve. Ay, ay, ay.
Es importante, ¿vale? Como en todo, como los vehículos, que no sufran si se queda irregular, porque las calles realmente.
Ah, okay. We don't not need to care about the smoothness of the surface, because if you see a real asphalt, except maybe in a highway, it's not smooth, has some different levels and
de hecho es importante porque si quedan cercos, si quedan cosas, luego los puedes tratar con pintura y va a parecer más real que si queda completamente. Okay.
So if you have that differences between the levels in the asphalt, then you can use it to make different effects with the weathering.
Ahora la paso.
From time to time, you need to clean and
siempre esto siempre para que no arrastre.
Has to be clean. If not, you remove with the paste.
Para mí este sería un buen acabado, por ejemplo.
Ahora lo pasamos, que lo vean.
Sí, pásalo y que lo vean. Y sobre todo lo que digo, que los cercos que quedan, y eso es interesante porque vas a conseguir ahí que la pintura funcione de otra manera.
You will see now that there are some small level differences. That's the best instead of a really small surface.
Preparándome otra para aplicar otra, ¿vale?
Ahora sí, la marrón, ¿no?
Sí. Ahora cuando vuelva la pasta.
Estará por ahí. It doesn't matter the size. The best is to.
Sí. De hecho, el camión es así, la superficie. It doesn't matter. Pero dile que, perdona, sorry, que tiene que trabajar. Por, es decir, que no conviene.
But in larger surfaces, do not try to cover in one step, little by little. Yeah, maybe this size you apply in four times, different times.
Ahí ahora mira, vamos a enseñarles una cosa también. Con estas pastas pueden conseguir.
Ah, vale.
Este tipo de.
Okay.
Díselo, haciéndolas más líquidas con
if
agua.
If you add to the paste this one
water,
a little bit of water, you can do the
textura, la textura gorda,
the weathering and texture effects on the vehicles.
Okay. Está aplicada la pasta y luego óleos, todos los demás.
First efectos, you apply pero, the paste.
¿Vale? Y sobre todo esto es lo importante, que estas pastas son muy duras.
You will see that first you apply the paste with some water. Let it dry, work with oils, and when it's finished, it's so hard. You can touch. Ok, thank you. Toma, ahí tienes.
Ah, muy bien, perfecto. Ahora continúo con la otra. Y así lo ven. Ahora sí que
necesito. Esta es de. No, de aquella. No, porque estás con gas.
Ah, vale, vale, vale.
No sé, por si acaso.
No, vale, vale.
Tú a ver si. Believe me that it's quite easy to do a ground. I live in Spain. I was in a clinic in Almería with him, and I almost finished three different, one deserted, one muddy, and one with the snow in a day and a half. You can do and speed up your process because in 2 hours it's dry.
Únicamente necesita después un poquito de óleo, es decir,
sí, se lo he aplicado, los óleos, sí, sí.
Okay. Vale, vamos a aplicar ahí la pasta, vale,
un pincel
para aplicar, exactamente.
It's important to use.
Pasa ese si quieres.
Ah, very is, you know, text is very bad. Don't use a good brush. It has to be a hard whistle. And you can buy the cheapest one.
Okay.
What?
He made the base from plastic. This thing, Roman plastic.
¿Sobre plástico también?
Funciona igual. Sí, el vehículo sobre.
That, where is the?
No.
Is there the vehicle? It's the same, it stick perfectly on the plastic.
You can see the paste of a plastic piece, okay?
You don't need to add glue anything.
No.
It adheres perfectly. Venga.
Vale. ¿Cómo aplica? A ver, ¿así se ve bien?
Sí, 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 sí. You see, the application is very simple.
Tú puedes acumular donde quieras. Lo más importante es el relieve que lleva el foam, es decir, con la pasta no consigues, ¿vale?
Okay, the most important, as you can see, is that we previously worked in the base with the brush. Because if not, you will need a large amount of paste.
Pero, ¿eh? Lo pasamos.
¿Baja el dedo? Sí. Ahí, así. Espérate.
Sí.
Ahí.
Dale, y ahora voy a aplicar, para que lo vean, un poquito de agua aquí, para que vean cómo es muy fácil.
¿El seawater o el paddles?
Voy a aplicar el de paddles, que ya tiene.
Acércamelo. Color,
pero, sí. Lo ahora explicamos, ¿vale?
Acércamelo.
Sí. A ver, esto y esto.
Ok, now let's see these two products. Okay, as he's working one side and the other is dry, he's going to add some paddles. The difference is that this one has color, okay, a brownish color, and this is transparent. So it depends what you want to add, a clean water or dirty.
Les has comentado lo de la diferencia, vale, que sigue siendo acrílico igualmente y demás.
Lo pasamos, ¿no?
Espera que le voy a poner.
Ah, vale.
Lo pasamos con el agua. Vale. Les has comentado que se puede teñir con.
Ah, no, ok.
Que esto.
They are acrylic, so you can mix with any acrylic color. Green, blue, whatever, you can add.
Transparent, and you add the acrylic color. Eh?
Okay, so if you want to make a greenish or a green or a blue puddle, you mix this with any acrylic blue color and you have the shade. But if you do not want to invest time and you want a dirty puddle, you use this one. It's important to
shake.
To shake a lot.
ahora se nota.
Sí.
And look, it's quite simple. You do not need any tool. Straight ahead from the battle.
Vamos a ver, lo voy a añadir en los valles.
Yes.
Okay, y lo voy a distribuir un poco con agua, ¿vale?
Okay, first,
hay que aplicarlo en capas finas e ir añadiendo, ¿okay?
First you apply with the bottle, small amounts, when you
y después lo,
what you need.
Después lo distribuiré con el pincel.
Pero primero aplicamos esto, ¿lo ves?
Sí. Ah, sí, sí, sí.
Sí, sí, sí. Por lo más en el centro, para que se vea la diferencia, uno en el centro allí,
sí,
porque ahí como está húmedo a lo mejor, ya, y otro, sí, ahí mira en ese,
mira, sí, sí,
ahí.
Ok, first you apply the product.
No hagas mucho, así ven la diferencia, ya está. Y ahora con agua y un pincel.
And now with a brush and some water, you blend the edges, okay?
Y mira ya el aspecto que tiene de agua, ¿sabes?
Sí, 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 ahora se lo vamos a...
Vale, así de rápido, sería.
Y ya, pues si no hay ninguna pregunta más.
Claro, ¿qué nos queda? Ya está.
Ya
está, ya hemos terminado.
Claro, sí. Preguntamos.
Any question about the products or anything? Don't be shy. It's the best way to learn how to apply, but it's quite simple.
Es una cuestión de luego imaginación y de práctica y probar. Y
it's a question of use our imagination and at the same time real references.
Pero es importante esto.
When he hit the truck.
Yeah.
Hands or with
masks. Which part of the truck?
Camouflage.
Los camuflajes que lo suele hacer a el camión que tiene camuflaje.
El camión está con Panzer Putin.
With Panzer Putin.
For example, but you can use,
sí,
all the type of.
Sí, pues se le puede decir que se le ha sacado un libro de eso, todo no quiere decir nada.
¿De qué?
Decir el libro nuevo que va a salir todo esto explicado de los carros o no. No.
Okay, you can use Panzer Putty, but you can do with the masking tape. Depends, free hands.
Depende del camo.
It depends of the camo, the type. But on the truck is with Panzer Putty.
Está el terreno por
allá. Ah, está allí. Tú tienes, pon, no te has traído una tarjeta. Por si, sí, te quieren preguntar algo,
sí,
pues espérate,
sí, sí,
la pones aquí y,
sí, sí, sí,
y la ven. So if you have any question, you can see his email here.
My mail or...
Maybe you can zoom in. I don't know if you can see it. Let's see. I don't know. Okay.
Okay. Hola de YouTube ya. Bueno, ya.
Yes. And you can ask whatever you need.
Okay.
Okay.
Oh, just a minute. Thanks. I got it.
Okay. So that's all. Thanks a lot for your
many thanks to all. Okay. See you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Cerveza, cerveza, beer. Okay.